having a great suspension on your motorcycle but failing to know how to adjust it properly, it's basically as useless as your grandmother's favorite set of antique dishware. On this short series of short videos, I'm going to teach you how to adjust the suspensions on the T7 or on a similar motorcycle. I am not a suspension expert, so this tutorial will be insufficient for racing purposes. But for the common Joe, like you and me, this will be everything you need to know to get you going and to understand a little bit better your own motorcycle. To begin unveiling this mystifying black sorcery, the first thing you need to know is that a suspension has inside a spring and it's filled with oil. The spring is basically responsible for pushing and holding up the weight of the motorcycle and the rider. The oil is responsible for damping or slowing down the movements of the spring as it compresses and decompresses. You can change dramatically the way a suspension behaves by changing the spring rate of the spring or by changing the speed at which you allow the oil inside the suspension to move. But not all the motorcycles and all the suspensions are exactly the same. On the T7, you can adjust the compression and the rebound on the front fork. On the shock, you have the compression, the rebound, and the preload. But what do all these names mean? That's exactly what we are going to talk about on this first video, and we will begin with the preload. Turning this knob right here allows you to regulate the preload, and what this does is to compress or decompress just slightly the spring on your monoshock. A compressed spring will be stiffer, and so it will push the rear of the bike up, thus preparing it for extra weight like luggage or a passenger. Never think of the preload as a way of making the bike feel stiffer or softer or taller or shorter. This adjustment is just a way to make sure the bike behaves exactly the same with extra weight as it does without it. And that's why even on older motorcycles you have preload adjustment on the shock but not on the front, because the extra weight is usually applied here when you have a passenger, here with the top case, or here with side panniers. There is a lot to talk about when it comes to preload and spring rate, so we will do it on the next video. But now let's move on, let's talk about the compression. On the T7 you can regulate the front compression here on the bottom of the fork, and on the rear you can do it on this screw right here. The compression adjustment allows you to speed up or slow down the speed at which the oil moves when the suspension is being compressed. If you increase the compression by turning clockwise the compression screws, you will be making the suspension harder to compress because the oil will be moving slowly. On the other hand, if you unscrew the compression, if you make it softer, then the suspension will compress easier. Overall, a soft compression is good at slow speeds dealing with big obstacles or at medium speeds dealing with very small obstacles, because it will give you a smooth ride. On the other hand, a soft compression is bad when you ride aggressively, because if you find a big obstacle and you are going too fast, the suspension will bottom out. And that is why it's so important to adapt the suspension adjustments to our own riding style. What about the rebound? The rebound is also available both on the front and the rear, and it works exactly the same as the compression, but this time it only affects the suspension when it's going down, when it's decompressing. So, if you make the rebound slower by turning the screws clockwise, you will be letting the suspension decompress slowly, and if you turn the screws anti-clockwise, you will make it faster. The suspension will want to recover faster. Overall, a soft or a fast rebound is good when you are an aggressive rider, when you ride really fast over very big obstacles and you need the suspension to recover from one obstacle to the next. But this also means that the suspension will always be fighting to extend as fast as possible, and this is bad for your traction, especially at slower paces, during turns or in compact soil. So usually people that are not racing the motorcycles will benefit from a slightly slower than a faster rebound. Alright, and now that we know what the preload, the compression and the rebound is, I need to teach you how to adjust them, how to measure everything and how to figure out what's the best adjustment for you. But instead of making a huge video, that would be very boring and very extensive, I will divide this in maybe 4 smaller videos. So for now, this is it. Next on the menu, it will be a video about how to measure and adjust the spring preload. This becomes especially important if you own a T7 because this bike is known for having soft springs, considering what it's capable of doing off-road. So it's very important that you know how to measure the sag so you can regulate the preload adequately. And for now that's all. Please like, subscribe, hit the thingy and share. Happy rides!